What's up, you guys? My name is Josh, also known as Harry Tornado, and I'm a full-time eBay seller. And for pretty much the entirety of my eBay career, I've gotten most of my inventory at thrift stores and yard sales. But today, I'm changing it up a bit. This store you see right behind me, Dream Deals, is in Columbia, South Carolina. They just opened a couple weeks ago, and basically this store sells Amazon returns. Anytime somebody returns something to Amazon, Amazon doesn't like package it back up and sell it again. They just send it to companies that sell it in pallets, and the owner of this store just buys all the pallets and just puts everything out in bins for us to go through. Everything in this store on restock days, which is Friday and Saturday, is $6 each, no matter what the item is. Some of it is junk, crappy cell phone cases. Some of it is $100 to $500 items. You never know what you're gonna find in here. So they open at 9 o'clock. It's currently like 7:15 or so. I got here and I thought I was gonna be the first one in line, but as you can see, there's a couple people setting up some camping chairs behind me. So I'm actually surprised there's not a bigger line than there already is. So we're gonna go here and maybe I'll talk to some people and see if they're willing to be in the video and tell me what their thoughts are about this store. I came last week, 2 or 3 days last week, and found some really, really good stuff. So I'm excited to see what they have today. So I've been chit-chatting with some people in the line ahead of me, and we're all just so excited. We're what was your name? Do you want to?
Brett.
Brett. Mm-hmm. Brett. This is Brett. He's he got laid off from his job just like me, and now he's selling stuff on eBay. So it's pretty cool. You come here and everybody kind of has the same mindset about like finding deals, flipping it. You know, the whole entrepreneurial mindset. I scraped some dew off the window here. I was going to see if I could. That's what everything looks like in there. You can't really see much, just boxes, but it is very exciting knowing that I only got to beat these three chumps ahead of me to get any good deals. So it's currently like 8:40. This place opens at 9, so I've been here, I don't know, like an hour and a half, 2 hours almost, something like that. Just talking to everybody, just having a good time. You can see the line's getting a little bit longer. Probably, I don't know, last time when I came here last Friday, the line was like wrapped all the way around that back parking lot. We were up to this building almost, so it's still not... last Saturday, actually. I feel like more people come on Saturdays because they're off work. But still, I mean, you can see people pulling into the parking lot here. So I'm thinking that getting here early was definitely worth it for today, at least. So like I said, we got about 20 more minutes or so until the doors open. So I'll keep you guys updated. We're about 10 minutes away from getting inside the door here. There's the owner right there, the guy who gave me permission to film. He said I can't have my backpack strap. I can't have a backpack in here to, you know, that's just one of the rules. So I have to use my GoPro head strap today. And I'm gonna be honest with you guys, it takes a new level of confidence to walk around in public with a GoPro strap to your head. So we'll see how this goes.
I'm gonna come to the back and explain everything as well. We have two opening stations. If you want something open, come to them. We'll do it for you gladly. Don't do it yourself, you're not allowed. And or go to one of the people with the orange vest, they'll open the items for you as well. If you're with kids under 16, just keep them close to you. That's pretty much it. And yeah, have a good time, enjoy yourselves.
No, because they're facing.
All right, see the line. This is fun. Look at how many people there are. This is even a bigger line than it was last Saturday. Yeah, it's definitely worth it getting here early. To be completely honest with you guys, I do not have a strategy for this store yet. I just put my bag in my buggy and just walked around until I found something that caught my eye. All right. There's another ink. So Dante,
hey, how you doing?
How's it going, man? You got it. You got a report. I'll be in your video. You be in my video. Look at that.
You doing all right?
Doing good, man. Got anything good?
Yes. This, I think, wood lobber. I think it's worth like $500.
Oh wow.
One barrel or something like that.
That's awesome, man.
That's crazy.
You beat me out today.
That's it. That's it. We got a whole cart full.
I haven't really scanned anything yet.
Oh, okay.
I'm just grabbing.
Good to see you here.
You too, man. You guys will notice here that I have a ton of stuff in my buggy that I haven't shown you in the video yet, and that's because I wanted to just pick up stuff in bulk and then take some time to go through it later and scan it then. And this right here, what you're seeing that I'm putting in the buggy, is the stuff I'm keeping. Everything else I went ahead and put back. So this that I'm putting, all this stuff right here, this is a pack of blocks, a vacuum in the back, the Brother Ink, the CB radio, two parting kit, Lego, all that stuff I'm actually keeping. Everything else I put back. You guys found anything good?
A few things.
You think? Did you find your Instant Pot lid?
No.
Dang.
Didn't see it.
Yeah, a couple things. We got some Brother toner cartridges that should sell pretty well. What is that Bosch thing right there?
Brake pads.
I'll take a look at them. I don't know anything about brake pads, but. That can be good depending on the brand. Yeah. How much was it?
$120. It sells for $120.
That's awesome. Lippmann Classic 3.
Found the tablet thing.
I'm more excited about the Lippmann. Yeah. That's awesome. What's up, man? Card. It's fine. One, two. Yeah, that's fine. I got my own IKEA bags. I brought these with me. So I'll just take everything out and then put them back in the bag. Alright, thanks, man. You too.
Get out of here.
Thank you. All right, guys, so I think I'm done for the day, at least at that location. It was pretty good. We got 25 things. I spent $166, I think, $6 a piece, 25 things. And I think we got some pretty good profit. So once I get home later on, I'll show you guys everything we got and give you an estimated total profit amount. All right, you guys, so fast forward like 5 hours into the future. I left that bin store around 11:15, 11:30 or so. I spent about two and a half hours in there. Found some really good stuff. I'm really excited to share this stuff with you guys and let you know my projected profit margins. However, I did go to the Goodwill pretty much right next door to the bins place today. I spent like $30 altogether, and I got about $150 worth of profitable items from that store. I'm not going to tell you guys what the items are in today's video, but if you want to see what I picked up at Goodwill today, go check out my Instagram. I'm at Harry Tornado. A lot of you guys probably already follow me on there, but I'm trying really hard to get up to 10,000 followers on Instagram so I can do the swipe up feature on there to share my videos from YouTube on there. So if you guys are not following me on Instagram, go do that. You can check out what I found at Goodwill today. A lot of good items at Goodwill. So shameless plug, follow me on Instagram. So I got a total of 30 items at the bin store today, but only 25 of them were to resell. I'll quickly show you the five I got for personal use because I think they're pretty cool anyway, but the last 25 items are the only ones I'm actually gonna try to sell for a profit. First up, I got this 20 pack of Orbit gum. I love Orbit gum. I usually buy it at the gas station for like $1.50 a pack. So if I bought $1.50 times 20 would be $30, right? $30. I spent $6 on a pack of gum. Not a pack of gum. I spent $6 on 20 packs of gum. And this will overall save me a good bit of money. It will save me $24. So I think this was a good purchase. I love Orbit gum. I probably shouldn't chew gum when I'm trying to do a video. Fresh breath. Next personal item is this foldable monitor stand. I wanted a stand to put my computer monitor on for a while now. I've been looking on Amazon over the last couple weeks trying to find one that I like, but usually they're like $25 to $35 or so. So this was $6, still new in the box. I haven't opened it. I don't really know what it looks like, but really I just need something to pick my monitor up so I can have some extra storage space underneath, which this appears to be exactly what that is. So $6, personal use, I think it'll do great. Another personal item, this is a set of decorative LED bubble string lights. I wanted to get some lights back here on this shelf, like some string lights back there to, I don't know, just add some ambiance or something to my videos. Yeah, like little ice balls. They plug in. Let's see what they look like. I'm gonna untangle them later, but for now, let's put them right here. Look at that. That looks so good. That's some ambience. Next up, I got some GE Refresh LED light bulbs. These are daylight bulbs, which are really good if you want to use like regular lamps for eBay product photography. You can use daylight bulbs, which give a really nice like cool temperature. Not like your house lights look like this, kind of like the orangey kind of warm temperatures, but you don't really want that kind of light for eBay product photos. So I like these for my eBay setup, and I also like them for my house setup because it gives a more like sunshiny feel rather than like the orangey or I don't know. I just prefer these lights. Not a lot of money here. This is just personal. The hallway light has been burnt out for like 2 months now, and I haven't gotten a new light bulb, so this is perfect. I got this next item from Moe's. It says AMZ Pets. Maybe that's Amazon Pets, but it's a little bag of dog toys. So we got some squeaky carrots. We got some rope that doesn't squeak. We got a pamphlet. That's probably your favorite, right? No, not interested in the pamphlet. We got another duck that squeaks. God, your breath stinks. We got a little, the heck is that? We got a little chewer. Some more rope. Just dump it all out. Some balls, carrot. Here, take whatever you want. Let's see what you pick. Duck. Good choice. Love you so much. So that is everything I got for personal use, me and Moe's. So now we'll move into the profitable items I picked up. First item we got is a Midland CB radio. This is a pretty decent brand of CB radio, model 1001LWX. Brand new, sealed in the box. I've noticed that at this store, you do actually want to check to make sure things are sealed in the box because it's an Amazon return store. And we all know that people abuse Amazon returns. Today I found a pack of Yu-Gi-Oh, like one of those 10 Yu-Gi-Oh card things, open it up and all the packs were opened up. So somebody bought it on Amazon, opened all the packs and returned the empty packs to Amazon. And I'm sure they got a complete, all their money back, you know? So that's a little frustrating. So if you find stuff like this that appears to be new in the package, make sure you check it to make sure it is new in the package. This was, I wanna say this sells for like $35, but I'm not 100% sure. Whatever it says on the screen is accurate. I got this Wonder Warmer. It's like a little personal like ceramic heater type thing. It's probably not worth a ton of money, maybe like $20 free shipping. But personal heaters are gonna start to sell a little bit better as we move into Q4 and the colder months. Also, I'm trying to put newer items in my store. Like going into Q4, the things that are gonna sell are gonna be new in-box items. Some people may be interested in buying used things for gifts this holiday season, but for the most part, people are gonna want new in-box items, which is why I really like this Amazon store, because you're able to get a lot of stuff that's new in-box. So nothing too crazy here, maybe, you know, $15-$20 or so. Same thing with this next item. Let's get you zoomed in over here. You see that? It's a, what does it say? Folomov EDC C4. It's like a little flashlight, small flashlight, big power bank. Small flashlight, big power bank. Brand new, sealed in the package. Paid $6, and I can sell it for like $10-$12 plus shipping, something like that. Really good stocking stuffer. So I went over to Amazon just to see if I can find the actual flashlight, Folomov EDC C4. This one looks similar. It's a limited time deal for $16.41, but it doesn't have the exact model number, whereas this one over here is the exact model, EDC C4, and it is $36.28. And if you look down here, there's two more listings, $34.75 and $36.28. So I think this was a great pickup. I just took some time to put the lights how I wanted it instead of keeping them in a little ball. And look at that. Look how good that looks back there. Perfect. Ambiance. What's going on, you guys? So I'm sure you're wondering why I just changed clothes in the middle of a video. And it's because last week when I was filming this video and I had that one shot zooming in back to the lights to get that one little shot, the camera focus never corrected. So for the whole second half of the video, I was completely out of focus and I couldn't use that footage. So I'm just re-recording everything. So hope you guys had a great weekend. My weekend was good. The next item I'm going to show you that I picked up has actually already sold. So that's a pretty good segue there. I found a total of four of these Brother TN660 toner cartridges. I listed them on Friday, one eBay listing with a quantity of four, really easy to list. One of them sold like 3 hours after I listed it for $42.99 free shipping. That one cost like $10 or so to ship out because it was going to California, I think. And then the other three sold to one buyer like an hour ago. Today's Monday, so over the weekend. So all four of them have sold within 3 days or so. And this guy paid $128 shipped for all three of them. And just going to Tennessee, I'm in South Carolina, so it's probably going to cost like $12 or $13 to ship. So I really like when people buy multiple quantities of stuff like this for me because it almost always makes me more money. So four of these toner cartridges for $6 a piece, that's $24. And I turned that into like $160 minus shipping. So probably like $130-something profit just in 3 days. Not too bad. Next up is this four pack of Polydent denture cleaner. I paid $6 for all of it because it's one sealed unit. And I think I could probably get like $20 plus shipping for this. There were a few sold comps of like a two pack for like $16.99 free shipping. So I think if I list this for $20 plus shipping, it should sell pretty quickly. Then I got two of these advanced teeth whitening systems from Asave or whatever. I think there were some sold comps on each of these for about $24 free shipping. So I thought that was pretty good. Pay $6 a piece. I think there were like six or eight total that I found, but I didn't want to take a chance on all of them. So I just picked up two. Just going to try it out on eBay, get them listed, and see if they sell. I picked up this Lego Junior set. I was kind of surprised to find Lego. I found some Mega Block stuff last week, but obviously Lego is better than Mega Blocks. But I think this sells for like $18 plus shipping, something like that. I'll throw a comp on the screen. But it's sealed, brand new, and definitely something I want to have in my store going into Q4. Picked up this used textbook, if you couldn't tell by all the stickers they put on this bad man majama. So this was very weird to look up. I couldn't scan the barcode because they covered it with the sticker from Amazon, but I searched the title. It's called Combined Volume by the People, A History of the United States by James W. Frazier. And there are multiple sold comps for this book with this author, but all of the sold comps I'm seeing on eBay have a different picture on the cover. I cannot find any sold comps with this picture. But the other books, same title, same author, everything like that, just different picture, are selling anywhere from $40 up to like $128. So for $6, I took a chance on this. Maybe it's like some rare version that's gonna sell for $200. Worst case scenario, bottom of the barrel, it's gonna sell for like $30. And books are really easy to list as well. So I took a chance on this. I think it'll pay off. Another book I took a chance on, this is an operator's manual for a forklift truck from Hyundai Construction Equipment. Brand new sealed, still got the shrink wrap on it. This is another item that I could not really find a sold comp on. There were other forklift manuals by Hyundai that are selling for like $90, but something like this is very, very particular. There's only so many people in the world that are looking for a manual for this exact model of forklift, you know? So it's definitely gonna be a long tail item in my store. It may be listed for upwards of a year, but if I can pay $6 for something like this, it's super easy to list, really just two pictures and just let it ride. And eventually it sells for $90, I'm totally fine with that. Then I picked up three of these Wellution Detox capsules. Not 100% sure what they do other than detox. They did not have a UPC barcode, they just had the barcode for Amazon. So I just typed in the name Wellution Detox capsules and found it on eBay. I think these are selling for like $20 or so. I'll throw up a comp on the screen. But $6 a piece. Again, I found like 10 of these, 10 or 12 of these in the store, but I didn't want to invest that much money into something that didn't have a ton of sold comps at the time. I think the best thing about these is that they don't expire until 2023. So I have plenty of time to sell them before they expire. I think worst case scenario, if they don't sell this calendar year, once we get into January, February, when people start their diets, new year, new me, all that stuff, they're gonna be looking for things like this. And if I have a multi-quantity listing, maybe one buyer will buy all of them since they don't expire for another 2 or 3 years or so. So took a chance on this. Don't really know if it'll pay off, but it's some, you gotta take chances sometimes, you know? Here's something else I took a chance on. This is a gold EDT LiPo Plus high discharge live polymer battery, okay? I have no idea what this is. I actually found it out of the box at the store. It was just sitting here like this, and I thought it looked new. It still has a little plastic shrink wrap around it. The plugs look, let's see if we can... The plugs look like they've never been plugged anywhere. They're not, you know, dirty or anything like that. So I don't know. And after I found this, I almost was about to put it back, but then I found the box to it. Honestly, I'm not 100% sure what the sold comps were on this. I remember I looked it up in the store and it was good enough to buy. I think it was like $35 free shipping. Not 100% sure. I'll try to throw them up on the screen here. But you know, stuff like this, it's new in the box, it appears to be unused, a decent sold comp. I'm just gonna take a chance on it for $6. You know, worst case scenario, I'm out $6. Best case scenario, I make like a $25 to $30 profit, you know? So Again, got to take chances. I found some of this Pantene Silver Expressions Gray, White, and Silver Moisturizing Conditioner, Pantene Pro V. Anytime I see Pantene Pro V, I always look that up, whether it be a thrift store or even like a clearance section of like an Ollie's or a Big Lots or something, because Pantene, if it's discontinued, it can actually be worth a pretty good amount of money. I'm not sure if this one is discontinued, but sold comps on this are like $25. I found one on Friday when I went and filmed for you guys earlier in this video, and then Haley and I went back to the store Saturday. I didn't film, we were just straight shopping, and I found like five more of these. So I got like $125 worth of this Pantene stuff. Again, one listing, quantity of five, super easy. It's all brand new, sealed, never used. I love finding stuff like this. I think this is going to be a real money maker for me. I picked up this number 7 Lift Illuminate Triple Action Anti-Aging Skincare System. Brand new, sealed in the box, never opened, no box damage or anything like that. I think sold comps on this were like $30-$35 or so. So pretty good. Pretty good pickup there. Paid $6, you know, maybe making $20-$25, something like that. Pretty good. This next one is really interesting. It's not really worth that much money, but when I found it, I knew I just had to have it. Something that has always just piqued my interest, I guess, are sea monkeys. I've never had them. I've always been curious about what they actually are. I know they're like some shrimp, like freeze-dried shrimp or something, but I just love this packaging. This is The Amazing Lives Sea Monkeys on Mars. I thought this was super cool. Apparently, it's got the sea monkeys in the back down here. You just add water and they live up to, guaranteed to live 2 years, says down there at the bottom. And I just thought this was kind of cool. Like, the graphics of the box are really neat. It's kind of like a, I don't know, like, it gives me a vintage toy vibe. Sold comps on this were not great, like $10 plus shipping. I didn't really buy it to sell. I might keep it, I don't know. I just thought it had a really cool look to it. And for $6, I can't really say no to something like this. Got this Philips Avent Natural. Oh, wait, that's in Spanish. Philips Avent Natural, the most natural way to bottle feed. It's just like a newborn bottle starter set thing. It's got two big bottles, three little bottles, two pacifiers, and a bottle brush. There are a bunch of different models of this one. They have a glass version that's like green, like the green box, and I think that sells for like $40 or $50. The purple one, the natural, I think sold comps for like $35 plus shipping. So pretty good. I did open it, like the seal, the tape was gone, so somebody opened it, but I checked on it and it looks like everything is there unused. It's still got the brush, the two bottles. You can take out the cardboard here. Another three bottles are down there. Everything looks clean, unused. So I'll sell it as a new open box item and probably get close to that $35 to $40 mark. Picked up some more ink toner. This one is Canon 045H. It's a two pack, which is awesome. This was sealed, so they only charged me $6 for both of them. Each one of these should sell for about $69 free shipping. So really good pickup here. Little bonus for you guys here. I picked this up Saturday. This is another Canon ink cartridge, a number 119. This was all torn to bits, and I think a lot of people passed over it on Friday because they thought it wasn't sealed, but I got them to open it at the store, and the actual ink cartridge is still sealed in the plastic. So the box damage doesn't really matter that much. This, if it was new in the box, like perfect condition, it would sell for about $50-$55. But with the open box, but still sealed cartridge, not expired, I think I'd probably get about $40 for it. So still definitely worth picking up for $6. I got this nice pair of Gyro cycling gloves. Gyro, you can see that right there. Gyro makes like cycling equipment, like helmets and shoes. I picked up a lot of those. These are Gyro D-Wool cycling gloves. I scanned that barcode right there with the eBay app. Anytime I talk about scanning stuff on my YouTube videos, I always get people to ask me what app I'm using. It's just the eBay app. I'll take a minute to show you guys here. eBay homepage. You can see I've got 22 items that I need to pack and ship out today. I'm here making a YouTube video. You just type on this little camera, this little picture of a camera right here, and that brings up this screen. And then at the bottom, it has a picture of a barcode. It says scan a barcode. You just tap that, and then you can just scan any barcode. We'll scan this glove. Come on. And then it'll pull up gloves. So there are no sold items for these gloves on eBay, but as you can see here, they are listed and selling from the United Kingdom for $59 to $60, $52, $47. So I think these will definitely sell this Q4. Again, they're brand new, still have the packaging on there. I think this was a great pickup for $6. The very last item I have for you guys is this vacuum. This is a Sotek Cyclone Vacuum Cleaner SVC 1021-L. I found this. I honestly did not look it up in the store. I just saw that it was brand new, sealed in the box. I'm like, this thing's definitely worth $6. You know, like, no, there's no situation in the world where this thing's worth less than $6. Looked up Sold Comps. I think this is worth like $40 plus shipping or $60 free shipping. I think there was one Sold Comp for like $59.99 free shipping. It's kind of heavy, I guess. Maybe like four pounds. So might have to go FedEx ground or something like that. But I think $40 plus shipping, not too bad. So there you have it, guys. That's everything I picked up at that Amazon return store last Friday. If you guys are looking for stores like this in your area, I would just suggest maybe a Google search Amazon return store, because they all have different names. This one was Dream Deals. Dave Tesla Picker, his store is called Gimme Five. There's another Gimme Five in Greenville, South Carolina. A couple of them are called Ben Time. They just all have different names, but they're all Amazon return stores. So I think if you Google something like that, you should see some results. I kind of forgot to keep up with the potential profit of everything I showed you in the video. So I will do the math after I finish the video and then put that total here in editing. This is how much money I think I can make after fees, after shipping, from everything I showed you in today's video. Pretty good. Pretty good, I think. Whatever this is, I think it's pretty good. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it at all, be sure to hit the like button for me. It really helps me and the channel out a ton. And if you haven't yet, consider subscribing to this channel for more content just like this. Thank you guys for watching. You're the best, and I'll catch you guys on the next one.